Hello, and thanks for investing in the Kelly Tillage System for your farm. So you can get the most out of your equipment, I'll briefly take you through some key setup and maintenance tips to have everything running correctly. Before unfolding, ensure that your tractor's hydraulic flow rate is set around 20%, which is roughly 30 litres per minute. Walk around and inspect your machine. It's important to check that no chains are hooked on the frame, that the swivel bolts are in place and not broken, and that the height adjusting chains have not fallen out of their slotted plate during transport. Next, lower the front A-frame to working height. Unfold the wings, holding the hydraulic lever until the frame cylinder pins have centered in their slots. Lower the tail and the modules. After this, you should walk around the machine again. This time, checking that all chain links are straight and that the working height of all of the swivels is correct. They should be slightly high compared to the chains. Adjust them if necessary. Once all adjustments are completed, you can move off with all chains in working position. In heavy conditions, it's acceptable to raise the front A-pull to transport height. This will lift the front chains off the ground and reduce the load on the tractor. Lower the front A-pull once you're moving satisfactorily. The same applies for the tail and the modules. When folding the machine, it's important to first lower the front A-frame to working height, as this ensures that all the chains locate correctly on their transport rests. Fold the tail, then the wings, and finally raise the pull. After the wings are folded, raise the front A-frame up to transport height. You can then walk around the machine and check that the chains have located correctly on their transport rests. On the 30-foot machine, the valve on the main cylinder can now be turned to lock for transport. It's easiest to reset the folding sequence with the assistance of a second person, one person working the tractor hydraulics and the other performing valve adjustments. The machine must be unfolded for this procedure. Loosen the locking nuts on the valves marked S1 and S2. Using an Allen wrench, turn the adjustment screw clockwise on the valves S1 and S2 until they bottom out. Next, activate the tractor hydraulics until both wings stand vertically. The wings should come to a complete stop. Slowly turn the adjustment screw on S1 anti-clockwise until the left-hand wing starts to move. Adjust S1 another half turn past this point. Continue to activate the hydraulics until the left-hand wing is folded onto its rest and the fold sequence comes to a stop. Slowly turn the adjustment screw on S2 anti-clockwise until the right-hand outer wing starts to move. Unscrew S2 a further half turn past this point. Continue to completely fold the wings. With the machine folded up, tighten the lock nuts on valves S1 and S2. Loosen the locking nuts on valves marked S3 and S4. Using an Allen wrench, turn the adjustment screw clockwise on valves S3 and S4 until they bottom out. Next, activate the tractor hydraulics until the left wing stands vertical. Nothing more should happen. Slowly turn the adjustment screw on S3 anti-clockwise until the right hand outer wing starts to move. Adjust S3 a further half turn past this point. Continue to activate the hydraulics until the right hand wing is vertical and the unfold sequence comes to a stop. Slowly turn the adjustment screw on S4 anti-clockwise until the center wing cylinder starts to extend. Unscrew S4 a further half a turn past this point. Continue to completely unfold the wings. With the machine now in working position, tighten the lock nuts on valves S3 and S4. Thanks for taking the time to watch this instructional video. Hopefully, this has answered your questions and provided some valuable information. If you require anything further, please don't hesitate to contact the team at Kelly Engineering.